football's coming home. It's coming home. It's coming home. It's coming. Hello guys and welcome back to another video on the channel. Do hope you do enjoy it. Today we're picking our 26th man England squad for the Euros. And well, it's going to be an interesting one indeed. So if you do enjoy this video, do drop a like, do subscribe for more. And I shall get into this video as soon as possible. Do you think I'm making the right calls on some of these picks? Do leave in the comments. Cheers, guys. Right, hello guys, and welcome back to another video on the channel. I do hope you do enjoy it. If you do enjoy it, do press that like button, do subscribe for more. And we'll just make that a bit bigger for you guys to see. So, as you can see, my 26-man England squad is here. I think this is going to be the team for the Euros as it's coming out tomorrow. So hopefully I do get a couple of these right and we'll be doing a follow-up video to see how many got right. So I'm going to pick Dean Henderson, Nick Pope and Jordan Pickford to be our goalkeepers. Only because they're the only ones who are challenging the goalkeepers at the minute. I feel like if Nick Pope's having surgery on his knee. So if he doesn't go, then I think Sam Johnston will go. So it's either him or Sam Johnston for Nick Pope. I think Dean Henderson's going because he needs the experience of international football. And I think Jordan Pickford's going. He's got experience in tournaments, so he knows how to play in tournaments. He's already done it before with England in the World Cup where he got to the semi-finals. So I do think he hasn't let us down, so why not trust him to be our number one this season. I've gone with right backs. I've gone Trent Alexander-Arnold, Kieran Trippier and Kyle Walker. I feel like Reece James could be in for Trent, but I feel like with the 26-man squad, I feel like he's going to go with Trent in this one because Trent can play midfield, Walker can play centre-back and Trippier can play wing-back, left-back. So it's all different kind of positions. You've got experience in Kieran Trippier and Kyle Walker who can play who have played in the Euros before and World Cup before, so they've got experience and know how to do in these competitions. Our centre-backs, I've gone with Michael Keane, Tyrone Mings, John Stones and Harry Maguire. I know Harry Maguire is injured at the minute, but I feel he has to go. If he doesn't go, then we go with a back three. I feel like that's the best way to go, because if we don't have Harry Maguire, then I feel like most of our defenders aren't good enough to be doing that. So we'll probably go with Walker, Stones and Mings at the back, or Keane. If Harry Maguire didn't make the squad. If he didn't make the squad, then I think Eric Dyer unfortunately will be in, because Southgate for some reason likes that man. He loves what's his face, Eric Dyer, so much. That's why he won't get in my squad, but he will get in Southgate's squad in my opinion. Two left backs, there's only two up for debate really, Ben Chilwell and Luke Shaw. I think I start Luke Shaw in the Euros. If you want a wing back, then I'd probably start Chilwell. It's a difficult one to pick indeed. So my three holding midfielders are, no, four holding midfielders are Jordan Henderson, Declan Rice and James Ward-Prowse and Jude Bellingham. I've picked Henderson just for the experience. He knows how to captain a side. In my opinion, he should be England's captain already. I feel like he's a good leader on the pitch and he will learn. Declan Rice will learn a lot from John Henderson if they play together in the midfield. James Ward-Prowse is like a captain for his club, so that's why he's in for me. I feel like he's got that leadership. He wins the ball back every time, so for me, I feel like James Ward-Prowse gets in because of he's a good leader, and he hasn't got much experience for England, but I feel like he's got a lot of club football experience, which you probably need in a tournament. And you just need, for example, if he just started on the bench and he needed fresh legs for half an hour, then he would be very good. Jude Bellingham learning a bit like Dean Henderson. He'll learn a load from this tournament, I feel. And I want him to do well this tournament because I feel like he's a very, very good player. He will probably come in off the bench, unfortunately, with Jordan Henderson and Declan Rice in midfield. If Henderson's not fit, then I feel like we could be looking at Declan Rice and Jude Bellingham or a Jack Grealish or Mason Mount. Other midfielders, we've got the likes of Jack Grealish, very good player. He's already showed us how good he is. So he's a very, very good player in my opinion. I feel like he gets in. Phil Foden, he's not up for debate, is it? If he doesn't get in or doesn't start at this tournament, then what is Southgate doing? I feel like if we don't get to at least the semi-final of this competition with the young player we've got, I feel like Southgate has to go, in my opinion. Marcus Rashford, very good winger. I feel like he's found his best position this season and he has done very well for Manchester United. He'd be good on that left-hand side with Raheem Sterling on the other side, with Jadon Sancho and Mason Mount as our two on the bench. But Mason Mount can play midfield also. So Mason Mount just really very good, and Raheem Sterling done very well for England and hasn't let Southgate get down so far in his reign. I've gone with Harry Kane as our striker because he's a golden boot last World Cup. He's not scored at a Euro tournament so far, so hopefully this time he can score a few more goals and win a few more trophies. Jesse Lingard I've gone with because he did very well for West Ham in this recent loan spell. I feel like he's done everyone justice. I feel like everyone's been like, why is Jesse Lingard in this West Ham team? And it's like, he just scored loads of goals. That's why. Could he get in the United team? It's a very important for debate. Dominic Calvert-Lewin scored some vital goals for them this season. Very, very good to see. Dominic Calvert-Lewin gets in for me. And Mason Greenwood as our third striker, who we could also play out wide also. He can play out wide. He can play just behind the striker, play up front. So I feel that's why I've gone with him. This team on paper, I think we could get to the semi-finals, in my opinion. We've got the strength in depth also. I feel like we're weak in defence if Harry Maguire is not fit enough. But we shall see in this tournament. Nick Pope might not even go to the tournament due to a knee surgery, I said at the start of the video. So he might not go. But Jordan Pickford, our number one, and then Dean Henderson and Sam Johnston just behind them. Just in for me. Jordan Pickford hasn't let England down, but he's let Everton down, so it's an odd one, really. It's toughest job in football, really, at the minute, because we've got so many good players coming through. So that's my team for the Euros, guys. I'll be doing how you think the Euro 21 is gonna go like, and I really do hope you have enjoyed this video. If you have, do drop a like, do subscribe for more, and I shall see you guys later. Cheers, guys.